everybody, in this video I want to talk about the installation of the rock sliders from White Knuckle Off-Road that we installed on our FJ80. Now, rock sliders are one of those things that's pretty well taken for granted when you build an extreme rock crawler. They're just part of the package. But for those of us that do more scenic backcountry exploration, not so much. And I'm kind of guilty of that because, if I remember correct, the last set of rock sliders I put on a project that we did was back in the 90s, and I did it on a Suzuki Samurai that I built with the help of Mr. Four-Wheel Drive Sport Utility, Phil Howell, for extreme rock crawling, because at the time we were learning all about that stuff, and I was learning all about it. He was teaching me extreme rock crawling. We went up the sledgehammer, the jackhammer, the wrecking ball, Highway 20. We went to Moab. Rock sliders were a part of that package. Since then, I've really been more in search of scenic trails that I can explore rather than searching out extreme trails to test my ability. And so I just haven't really spent any time looking at installing rock sliders on any of our rigs. But then my son-in-law was out exploring one of the trails in Moab, and he came around a corner and, well, all of a sudden there was kind of a ledge and a rock and stuff that he thought, you know what, if I really go around this and drop off this, there's a chance I'm going to damage my rocker panels down here. And so he turned around and headed out a different trail. And that was a lesson because, you know, all of us that go out backcountry exploring, we want to see what's around that next corner, over that next rise, off that next ledge. And I don't like to be kept from that. I mean, that's why we put winches on, so that you get to some place and you can get yourself out of the bind. A rock slider is one of those things that it's going to keep you from doing some major damage to your rocker panels. And let me tell you, the price of a set of rock sliders is going to seem cheap compared to trying to repair a rocker panel on one of your vehicles. So anyways, I went on search in search of some rock sliders, and there's a lot of companies that build rock sliders, but I discovered White Knuckle Off-Road, and that's all they do, and I figured somebody that specializes in rock sliders ought to be pretty good at building rock sliders. And yeah, that is exactly the case. You get on there, and they, first of all, they make rock sliders for just about every vehicle there is. Then you get on there, and you've got a bunch of options that you can choose from. There's two different thicknesses of metal that they can be constructed out of, and you know, it'd be easy to say standard and heavy, but really it's heavy and really super heavy. Then you have your choice of whether to get them powder coated or just leave them in raw steel. You also have the choice of leaving them in the tubing form or getting them covered on the top with diamond plate. If you are putting them on like we did an FJ80, you have one other option, and that's the length of the sliders. You can get a little bit shorter slider that will fit behind your front mud flap, or you can get the longer slider and it requires the removal of your front mud flap. So basically, you know, I checked every box. I want the heavy dutiest one, I want it powder coated, I want the diamond plate, and give me the long one because I'm going to take the mud flaps off, because about the only thing that scares me nowadays is mud, and it's just a messy thing to deal with. Anyways, I get off track here. They arrive, the rock sliders arrive really well packaged, which is surprising, that you get something from White Knuckle Off-Road that is going to get scratched and tore up, and it comes in wrapped and packaged and is in pristine condition. So, you know, if you wanted to just hang them in your office or something, or your den, you could do that, and they would look very nice there. But I really kind of think they look nicer on the vehicle. Now, what's really cool about them is they come ready to go. I mean, there's all the hardware, there's a good set of instructions that come with them, and they bolt on really, really easy. The biggest problem you really have if you follow the instructions is, let's put the jack underneath it, floor jack underneath, and raise it up, because these are heavy. These are about 70 pounds each. So get that floor jack under, start jacking it up, and then put a a jack stand under each end to kind of hold it steady so that it's not going to fall on you when you're jacking and moving it into position. And then from there, it's an easy bolt-on because it comes with these U-bolts that will go around the frame members and bolt into the big, beefy hangers on the rock slider. So it's pretty much a case of just getting it in position and tightening it down. Now, the issue that I have, and I think is very specific to FJ80s, is the catalytic converters. And here's where I mumble under my breath something about the government and the EPA, but this, I can't understand what it is. You don't understand it either when you're back there trying to get these bolts in and get your nut. It's not white knuckles, but it's, you know, red knuckled. Anyways, on the side where the catalytic converter is, which is on this year on the passenger side, it U-bolts in two places. But then the forward mount is actually bolts behind the catalytic converter with four bolts into threaded spots into the frame. So it's difficult to get to. So I've learned three things, and this is after the fact, that I now can pass this on. And, you know, a wise man said it's really good to learn from your experience, but it's even better to learn from someone else's experience. So, learn from this. And I've learned this twice. I've had to learn it twice on the same vehicle. Anyways, before you get to the point to where you're going to bolt the side up with the catalytic converter, spray some WD-40 in those threaded holes in the frame to loosen them up, because they've probably been sitting there for a long time. Also, I have found this out, that if you take the bolts that you're going to thread in those holes, put them on your wire wheel and just clean them up a little bit. Make sure they thread in, because nothing's going to make this thing go better than to get in there and get your hands behind it and then have the bolt actually thread in to the nut. And then the final bit of advice was, I wished I would have elongated the four holes where it bolts to the frame, just elongated them about a quarter inch so I could push it up just a little bit tighter to the catalytic converter to get about a quarter inch more clearance. And really, in the end, I'm not sure that a quarter inch clearance was enough, because I'm sure I ain't taking them off again to adjust that quarter inch more clearance underneath there. So really, all in all, I'm finally a believer in putting rock sliders on your mild exploration rig. And you're going to see this, because now Elsie, which never had them on it, which is, I guess, becoming more of a classic, needs that protection. And even my really mild exploration rig, the Tundra that we're fixing up, I'm going to protect it, especially since it's long there. I'm going to protect it with a set of sliders too. So I am now a believer, because as I said, sliders are way cheaper than the damage you could do to your rocker panels. So, you know, we've showed you the website. If you want more information to see what they have, what options they have for your vehicle, contact White Knuckle Off-Road. I highly recommend them. And like I say, it's one of those things that someday you're going to be out on the trail in a situation, and just like that installation of the winch, or perhaps the bull bar that you put on, you're going to be going, am I ever glad I put rock sliders on my backcountry exploration rig? I didn't think I was ever going to need them. But when you do, you're going to be glad you got them. So that's it. We're moving on from here. I guess we move back towards the back and finally get going on our ARB back bumper. I think that's what's next. But anyways, I'll see you on the next video. Till then, God bless.